Chris Jenock here, Insight Media at CES 2025. I'm in the Shohei suite here at the Westgate. Shohei just bought Nanosys, so the makers of quantum dot devices. And what they're showing here is actually, I think the first time it's been shown in public, is a microLED display produced by CTC, a division of Foxconn, using applied materials equipment and processes along with Shohei quantum dots. So in this process, the whole idea is you manufacture UV quantum dots, UV micro LEDs, and then you pattern, inkjet pattern, red, green, and blue quantum dots. Clearly, red and green quantum dots have been commercialized before. Blue has not had much commercialization that I'm aware of. So why would you do this? Well, there's actually a number of reasons. One, the efficiency of the green when you have a UV exciter is much, much more efficient than you have a blue source to activate the quantum dots. You can also get a much better Lambertian response from this. So the color response and luminance response is much better across the angles compared to using either discrete devices or even just quantum dot converted ones that use a blue micro LED underneath. The device is about 1.2 inches in diagonal, about 300 ppi. Luminance is on the order of 1,000 nits, and they think they can get higher than that. It's also very efficient from a quantum dot, from an inkjet printing perspective. You can now deposit them all at the same time. You just turn on the device and they actually self-cure via the UV light, which is kind of interesting. And because they're all at the same height, these are all planar, that's what helps a lot in getting that the Lambertian viewing angle. Oh, and the other thing they're doing is the way they construct the pixel itself. So instead of having one micro LED per pixel, they do four micro LEDs per pixel and transfer that. I'm not sure exactly their transfer method, but they transfer that to some kind of a backplane. I don't know the backplane they're using here. But then the idea is you don't need all four to have a working display. So even if you have some dead pixels, that's okay. I don't know what their specification is. If you can have one dead emitter per pixel or two dead emitters per pixel, I don't know what the spec is, but clearly they can tolerate at least one dead emitter per pixel and still get a very high yield. And I'm told that this device is actually might even have only one dead pixel for that kind of a device, which is actually quite incredible. So a very different way of thinking about making micro LED displays, and we'll have to try if we keep learning more about what they're doing. Chris Chinnock here for Insight Media.